They're born around Neil Collins. Their crew is their brother Rob Collins. So let's do this for you. Take your mark. Back.
A lot of these are Garden Olympics medals, which are from an Olympics we have in our own house in Newcastle, which I organise and always make sure that no one's going to beat me. So, you know, these are partly, you could say I've bought these for myself. It's funny with medals, you get, when you're young, you get these such great medals, and, you know, as you get older, they get smaller and smaller to the point where you get nothing, you know, unless you finally win. Win a major champs. That's what I've got to do, just to get another medal. You know, obviously I'll be gutted, devastated if I don't make it next year. But that will be the last chance, you know, there's no doubt. I'll not be around for 2012. I just don't have my body to hold up to it by then, you know, one big push for Beijing and doing everything it takes to get me through that, and after that that's been done. There isn't anything I won't do. I couldn't think of anything that I would. If you couldn't think of anything I wouldn't do to make it.
I've written thousands of letters to companies. I've danced on the streets around the country. I've danced on the streets in Canada. I've danced on the streets in America. I ran a club night in Reno. I've been a stripper at Stringfellows. I had my own waitering company. I ran a five-a-side league with my brother Rob to raise money on a Sunday. So I've done a lot.
My coach Iggy is a long jumper, and he's hoping to go to the Olympics for that event for India. His dad, I think he's got a lot of connections over there in India with the Olympic people over there, so there's a possibility that I could compete for India. It's unreal being out here. I mean, how many people get the opportunity to do something like this with their best mate, covertly? No one knows we're out here, you know? Yeah. People think I'm retired.
Joked about it.
You know, we've already told people that we've already got bellies and putting on weight and, you know, starting to think about families and jobs and all the rest of it. And the truth is, we're out here to attack the 400 meter hurdles. We're just, you know, dreaming as big as we can. And
it's just like Rocky IV. We've just disappeared out of nowhere, gone to the most remote place, just to concentrate on all of our weaknesses
and just come back guns blazing for August the 4th. Absolutely guns blazing. I want to have absolutely no respect for the 400 meter hurdles. I've had it on such a pedestal for so many years. I want to come back and absolutely degrade it.
It's all about hemoglobin. That's why we're up here. We want to increase his hemoglobin content. He's pretty good at the moment. It's around 16 decigrams or whatever per litre. And we want to get him over 17, and you need to have 6 weeks high altitude training, which is why we're here.
It's a race of who can slow down the slowest. That's what the race is about. Who can slow down the slowest is the Olympic champion. And we're hoping that this will make me slow down that little bit more slower rather than drop off, bang, lactic acid.
Being a hurdler, it's all about plyometric ability.
In layman's terms, how strong my legs are to be able to cope with jumping over the hurdles.
One of the places we found here first day was a nice set of steps, and there's a certain exercise we call the frog march.
It's an all-encompassing thing. We're training 8,500 feet there, so you're battling against altitude, lactic acid, muscular fatigue. It's a really, really the hardest thing we'll probably do on the trip.
The goal is to get to the top of those stairs, which is 100 stairs up. With that training in mind, how we measure power is a standing long jump.
And 3 meters really is the benchmark. And I want to go beyond that, you know. I want to go into the realms of 3:10, 3:20. If I could get up to 3:20, anywhere near that, that would be absolutely ideal, really.
Yeah.
think I'm just getting nothing off this left flexor. It's like jumping on one leg.
You're never going to put out 100% if you're not totally right, man.
Yeah.
That's the difference between 307 and 320.
Yeah.
That's all it is. You got to be happy with repping out 3 metres for fun now.
I'm not happy until I get that 3 fucking 20. I've got to get it. No two ways about it. Yep. 8 centimeters to go. 8 centimeters to go here. Battling on like an ox. This is gonna be close.
Just allow yourself to hang a little bit.
Yeah.
You're snatching at the end.
Yeah.
That's it! That's the one. That is the one, I think we've got it. That's a 320 there.
.319. Personal best. Call it a day there.
Happy me.
I've twisted my ankle and the muscle in the side has gone really, really tight in its spasm. So Iggy's just trying to work it out, but it's just more bullshit. I have to assume that it's my fault, because if I put the blame on anyone else, it means that maybe I can't improve it, you know? But if I blame myself, then it means I can change it and I can make it still, you know? And to be honest, one serious injury, and that's our careers over now at 28 and 29. So we've got to be more careful. Which is why it's annoying we can't afford a physio, you know? If anyone actually believed what we were saying to anyone, if anyone believed half of what we were talking about, then we'd have a physio out here. But no one does believe us. I just feel it's been so long since I've actually done anything, you know, anything of any real value, that I don't have that high an opinion of myself, you know, to sort of say that it annoys me to not have physio, because there's a lot of other better athletes, far better athletes too, who should be getting physio, you know, and they don't. And I'd feel, a few years ago I probably would have, you know, said I was really really pissed off and gutted and stuff, but now I'd be embarrassed to say something like that, you know, because I don't feel like I warrant it yet, you know.
Well, my leg's still feeling really, really stiff. Haven't been able to do a great deal, really. I worked on upper body yesterday, and today we're going to meet Rajesh, Iggy's dad's friend, who's a Buddhist, and he's coming down from Shimla. He's very much into positive thinking, healing, the power of the mind, and as we're up here training the body, training the hemoglobin, the power of the mind is very important as well.
Recently, only 1 year ago, the Commonwealth Games, I was the first Englishman over the line. I was the first Englishman over the line. And I only just missed the qualifying time, only just by a couple of tenths of a second. So I wrote to the English Athletic Association, I wrote to them and said, I know if you take me to the Commonwealth Games, I know that I can get a medal. I know I can get a medal or finish in the top five at least, because my time was good enough to get in the top five in Manchester. My personal best was good enough to finish in the top five in Manchester. And even though I was the first Englishman past the post, they wouldn't take me. They wouldn't take me there because they didn't have the belief I could do anything there, obviously. Many may argue that I was just having a very bad time of convincing myself. Even if I'd convinced myself earlier on, then they would have been convinced so much quicker.
Every one of us are feeling limitations. You are feeling that you can do perform at the country level. Mm. You are not good enough for the Olympics.
Mm.
Mm. There is one phrase in the Buddhist philosophy, that is Nam Myoho Renge Kyo. Nam means I devote myself, I fuse myself. Fuse with what? Myoho, the ultimate truth, or the mystic law. So that is the unlimited power of the whole of the universe. So the moment you say that, the moment you fuse with that. And this moment you acquire that energy. Your self fuses with the ultimate self, ultimate law. So that is how it really works. Maybe some athletes better than you, beyond physical strength, beyond mental strength, you need to have a good luck, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
One can fall ill anytime.
Exactly.
So that's not granted.
Yeah.
You will not fall. So for that matter, one needs to have good luck.
Yeah.
In one's favor.
Yeah.
So that is the best thing. Namme Horenge is the best thing to chant and to have the storehouse of the good luck in your favor.
Yeah.
Whatever we are experiencing in our life, it is only through the
reaction of what
our thoughts, words and deeds.
Yeah.
Nam myo ho renge kyo. Nam myo ho renge kyo. Nam myo ho renge kyo. Nam myo ho renge kyo.
We spoke with Rajesh, you know, about how sometimes something bad happens, but it can often, something bad can just be something good, you know, disguised in a cape of negativity. But if that's the case, then, you know, perhaps it is, because now, this leg being bad, it's now meaning I'm strengthening the leg that's been the weakest always.
Hello, sir.
Right now, I'm not thinking about not making it at all. You know, I'm trying not to let a single negative thought get into my mind, because once it does, it spreads like a cancer, you know. And all I have to think about is just, what have I got to do to make sure, from the toes to the neck, you know, that everything physically is in place. It just feels different out here, you know. It just feels like magical, mystical. It feels like it's a difference. It's a new start. I feel I need in all this.
I don't understand what's happening. Someone's gone over the edge. You guys are on the bus, yeah? Everyone's okay? Yeah?
Rajesh, I can't believe it just hasn't gone all the way, you know? So lucky.
Absolutely lucky.
Look at that, you've seen the drop. I got into athletics when I was about 13, 14. It was after I saw Olympia Christie win 100 metres in Barcelona. It was such a wonderful period for British athletics. I was so lucky to get into athletics at a time where there was Olympia Christie, Sally Gunnell, Jonathan Edwards, Steve Backley, Steve Smith, Dalton Grant, Tony Jarrett. I mean, the list is endless. You know, all these people competing together, the world's best, you know, breaking records left, right and centre. And that was just like, it was so attainable because of all doing it. It was like, wow, yeah, that's what I want to be. I used to listen to them so much that I knew the commentary off by heart, you know. It's been a while, let me think. Barcelona 92. Right, it goes there. They get away first time. Christie got a good one. And it's Christie and Fredericks and Mitchell going well as well. And Christie comes through to become champion of the, to become the Olympic champion. The greatest prize in sport, 9.96,
He was the man from the gun, and his power over the last 50-60 metres was truly breathtaking. And the British captain is the Olympic champion. I used to know them all, you know. All of them. That's how sad I was. I mean, you got to watch a lot to know that, haven't you? Because I wasn't good at memorising stuff at school, so I had to see that a lot to know them. You see, the more I think about competing for Britain, you know, sometimes it does make me want to run for them, you know, it does. But my own experience of British athletics has been a failure. You know, I haven't done what I wanted to achieve. And to wipe the slate totally clean is like going back to 14 years old again. There's no limitations. That's how it feels. The thing was, when I grew up, I just wanted to run the Olympics, you know. I didn't see the Union Jack and say, I want to, you know, represent Great Britain. I wanted to run against the world's best.
Apparently the Chief Minister of Child's coming down today, so I'm quite excited to meet him.
I mean, my name is Liam Collins. But I'm thinking about changing my name maybe to Kalinda Singh.
Kalinda Singh, you know?
Rugby Singh. My name is Collins, so, you know, maybe, you know? Get everyone saying it. Kalinda Singh. When you see me on TV, you have to chat. You know, I've been mugging people. They bully me. Look, see, he's watching me. Yeah. I'm watching him. They look at me. I was like this, anyway. Yeah, all the time. Yeah, you want some now, eh? You want some now? I've got my boys here now. You have a bit now, look who I've got, you see? Want some now, eh? No talk, no
national championships in Delhi in December, and we have and I make the team for India.
Yeah.
Then we have
next year we have come to chance.
Yeah.
I will give you a full honor.
Yeah. Really like this?
Yeah, this.
And we'll have a party, dancing.
Full party.
Yeah. All day, all
that
night.
That is my full announcement for you.
Thank you very much, Jyoti.
That is my promise for you, not a joke.
Okay. Excellent. Well, my promise to you. I'm gonna break the national record in India to come home with a gold medal. Okay? That's my promise to you.
Thank you.
It's up to him whether he wants to decide to go for India. Then he will have almost automatic qualification because Indian record is 50.3, he is about 40 years old. It was from my school days, this record has not been broken.
Really?
Yes. I watched this race.
Yeah?
Yeah.
In terms of actually the logistics of him running for India, how are we going to do it?
I don't think it's very difficult for him to run for India.
We marrying him off?
That is the last option. I think we can find other ways to represent India. See. Well, we can put an ad for you.
Oh, you gotta have, you gotta, that's not what you do. You put an ad in the paper and say, you know, 6 foot blue eyes, Caucasian,
yeah.
You know, good heart, athletic build.
Yeah, you can put anything.
Not willing to compromise in anything.
Well, if you want, we can put an ad.
There's a lot of red tape in India, isn't there? We could have some problems.
Yes, so I think we'll have to break the red tape.
With a big pair of scissors.
I don't think we need to go through a big person. I think we need to go through the proper State Olympic Association.
A big pair of scissors. Not a big person.
Big pair of scissors.
But you've got the contacts from your early days.
I have contacts from there. But what we need to do is, first of all, we have to prepare you into a medal-winning position. Once you are in medal-winning position, once you connect, we have to put you in the nationals there. If you want to, really want to, if you don't want to represent England. By the back of my heart, I wish you go for England, but if you can't, England can't take you in. Your goal is to go to Olympics anyway, whichever route, whichever country accepts you. So we have to keep a second door open for you.
Janagana mana adinayak jaya hai Bharat bhagya vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravid Utkal Banga Vindh Himachal Yamuna Ganga Uchal Jaladi Taranga Tab Shubh Naam Jaage Tab Shubh Aashish Maage Gaaye Tab Jaya Gaata Janagana Mangal Dayak Jaya Hai Bharat Bhagya Vidhata
All right. How many have we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5 aside.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Okay. Come on, Rocky. Yeah. How cricket can I tell
it? Please, some bit.
He whiskey?
Yeah. He likes smoking.
Yeah?
Yeah.
He likes whiskey. He likes smoking. What do you like? He likes cricket.
Female.
Women.
Tell
me what everyone likes. Cheers! Cheers.
Okay!
Alright!
Alright! Chalo bhai chalo!
Alright!
Okay!
Empire signal!
Empire signal!
Well, come on, Harry! Come on!
place, man. Absolutely love this place. It's just, it's crazy, it's unpredictable. How can I go back and run for England after all this, you know?
Woke up at 4:30 in the morning, just shaking like a leaf, and so Captain Bry called the ambulance, got taken straight to emergency, and they just strapped me up. I've gone through 4 liters of that, which means I was chronically dehydrated. I've done tests for malaria with negatives. I've had a needle like that in my groin, just trying to get a pulse. I've had a needle in my armpits. And I've had a guy's finger up my arse. Took him 2 attempts, he's done with a flu. I've shut myself in bed. Pissed myself in bed. I've had a nappy on. And the good news is...
Hello, my darling. Hello, my darling.
The hemoglobin is 17. Which means it's all being worth it.
Hello. You
alright? My body has taken an absolute tonking. The bone marrow has been stressed. And the hemoglobin's up there. The only problem now is whether I'll ever run again. I believe hemoglobin of a mountain goat. And I can't even get out of bed.
Burning thing inside me is the fact that when I left athletics, I just was just disappointed. I felt like I hadn't put down a mark that reflected anywhere near what I can run, you know, nothing close. And that was the most frustrating thing. You know, athletics being such a big part of my life, and then being embarrassed to tell people what my best achievement was or what my best time was, you know. I need to run under 50 seconds, at least. I'd be proud of that, you know, that's something I'd be proud of myself. And I look back sometimes and I remember how passionate I was by then as a 14-year-old, 13-year-old. And I just think that, you know, I owe it to myself then, you know, to keep going and to do my best and to really try and make it.
Boxes off, please. Yeah. You stand 3 metres behind the line, face forward, and I'll signal to the staff that you're ready to go. Have a good race.